Hello everyone, so today I'm gonna show you guys how to make my favorite mushroom with pasta, and also on the side I'll be making some avocado salsa with some nachos. So tonight is gonna be a fun night, so follow me through the whole video for very easy straightforward recipes. Here, half a red onion that I have chopped up and it's frying up. I'm gonna go ahead and add just about half a tablespoon of salt. It's okay if you add a bit more salt, because we have to realize that the pasta does not have salt that we're gonna boil in the water. So I'm just getting this base of the sauce ready to go ahead and put in my pasta. Now I'm gonna go ahead and chop the mushrooms that I'm gonna put in here with the onions. So right now my onions are really fried up and they are ready for me to go ahead and put my mushrooms here. Here I have about 8 mushrooms that I have chopped roughly like so, because once I put it in here, it's going to start caramelizing with the onions and further shrink. And also I'm going to be adding 2 chopped garlic cloves right there. So I'm going to first put in all the mushrooms. And you can use any kind of mushrooms. I have brown mushrooms, you could use white mushrooms, but I find that brown mushrooms are a lot more flavorful than white mushrooms, which is why I use brown mushrooms. And then here, my 2 garlic, which I have already chopped and ready. You could add a whole onion. I just decided to go with half a red onion because it's very flavorful. And also I don't want the onion overpowering the smell of the mushroom and the taste of the mushroom. So here we go, it's in the pan. So now I'm gonna go ahead and mix everything together. So far what I have in here is about 5 tablespoons of oil, any vegetable oil. I had first put in the onions, the red onions, half a red onion chopped. I let it caramelize, then I went ahead and added my mushrooms and added 2 garlic cloves at the same time. I have about 8 mushrooms here diced up, 2 garlic cloves, half a red onion, and some salt. And right now, if we see, the water from the mushrooms are coming out. So the heat right now is on 2 because I want these to caramelize slowly so that it does not burn and catch, but we take out as much of the water from the mushroom as possible. And then what I'm going to be using to create the sauce after is this tomato and basil classic tomato sauce. So this is called the pasta sauce right here. You can add your own natural tomatoes to get it to make that sauce, but this is just faster and easier, and you can make this dish under 20 minutes if we have the pasta water going right now. Everything can be done at the same time and we toss it in and then that's it. We call it a day and it's done. So this is pretty much it. I'm gonna just let it keep simmering and cooking so we get the extra water out, and I'm gonna put the heat up to 3 here just so that it goes ahead and takes the water out from the mushrooms faster. And then that's pretty much it. It's a very simple sauce, yet very delicious. And so yeah, that's pretty much it for our sauce right now. We're gonna wait for the water to dry so that we can go ahead and add the pasta sauce to it. So at this point, it's been about 3 minutes that I just let it go ahead and simmer on its own. And as we see, the water has dried out. It's just the oil and the mushrooms now, and I can start smelling the mushrooms, that really nice barbecue-y sauteed smell. So at this point, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and put the pasta sauce in, which I have right here. And I'm gonna put in about half of the bottle because I want it to be really saucy. So here's the pasta sauce, and I'm gonna just go ahead and pour it until this part because I want it to be really saucy. So we're gonna just go ahead and pour it in. A little more. Okay, so here we go. Now all we have to do is just mix it, and at this point we're gonna bring the heat down to 2 because we do not want to burn the sauce. So So we just want it to lightly simmer and finish cooking. And at this point, I'm gonna close the top of the pan so that it can just simmer and cook away slowly, because we don't want to burn it. If we leave the heat too high, the chances of us burning the tomato sauce is high. So you see right now, it's this beautiful goldeny brown color, and the only spices I use is just garlic, and that's pretty much it, and salt. If you want, you could add fresh chilies, but I'm not going to add fresh chilies because I'm making, beside this, another dish that will have lots of chilies. So that's why I have omitted the chilies, but you can go ahead and add chili powder or chili flake or fresh green chilies if you would like. But tonight I'm not going to be adding any chilies to this. And you see how that's bubbling up? That means that our sauce is starting to cook through. So I'm going to just go ahead and put the cover so that it cooks and simmers slowly. And I'm going to just put it to simmer, because now I'm gonna go ahead and boil my pasta, so I don't want the sauce to burn out or get dried out by the time my pasta is ready. And this is as simple as it gets, guys. Okay guys, so I've kept my sauce on the side and I have put my spaghetti in the same pan because it has the oil, so it will stop my spaghetti from sticking. I have put in about a liter of hot boiling water, and I have put in 3 bunches of spaghetti. So this is 1 bunch, this much. But it really depends on you knowing how much fulfills your family's needs. And I have gone ahead and boiled this for about 10 minutes. Right now it's done. So I'm gonna go ahead and pour the water out, mix my sauce in, and then we are ready to serve this delicious spaghetti. And at this point, I did not put any salt in the spaghetti water because my sauce has enough salt, and the oil from my sauce, which was in the pan, is actually keeping my spaghetti from sticking together, which is perfect. So I'm gonna pour some of the water out and then go ahead and add my sauce to this. Keep about half a glass of the spaghetti water in case you wanna make your sauce a bit waterier instead of adding outside water, because that water will have the spaghetti flavor in it. So here we go guys, I've poured the water out from the spaghetti and just keep half a cup in the bottom of the pan here because I want my sauce to be a little runny. Now I have the heat on 4. So at this point, what I'm going to do is go ahead and add my sauce to it. I just kept the sauce separately because I wanted to use the same pan to keep the oil from the spaghetti in here, so that I didn't have to add more oil to the pasta to keep it from sticking. But if you don't want to do that, you can boil the pasta separately in a separate pot, and then just make sure you add about a tablespoon of oil so that they don't stick together. And then we're gonna just mix it in all the way and then go ahead and serve it. So guys, my pasta is ready now, so I'm gonna go ahead and serve it up. And here it is, guys. Delicious, warm, heart-filling pasta. So thank you for following me, and let me know if you have any questions about this recipe. This was so quick, easy to make, and very filling.